Bob's Burgers is the cute and character-driven animated comedy series focused on the Belcher family. Loved by many and numerous seasons deep, the show almost turned out quite differently, in a dark and cannibalistic kind of way. What exactly happened? Let's find out in The Court of Source. The story of Bob's Burgers begins with a young cartoonist by the name of Loren Bouchard. Bouchard was working as a bartender when he got his first big break creating a cartoon series called Dr. Katz, Professional Therapist. On Dr. Katz, he would explore everyday adult themes in an ad-libbed format that ended up running 6 full seasons and laid the roots for his future partnership with H Jon Benjamin.
You know, Dad, I can't go on living like this.
The future voice of Bob Belcher. After his success with Dr. Katz, he would enter into an agreement that helped launch the Adult Swim network. It would begin with a series called Home Movies, which focused on a bunch of kids doing just that amongst the realities of grown-up life. Here, he would further foster his relationship with H Jon Benjamin.
Maybe I'll do this where I touch your shirt and then hit your face.
Which would continue into his sophomore series on Adult Swim called Lucy, the Daughter of the Devil.
I drank 4 apple teenies and...
Dad, I can't really talk right now.
At this point, it would be clear that Bouchard's focus was on adult-oriented content, a point he would eventually address about the darker intentions for Bob's Burgers, stating that it was needed to cut through the noise. After his second run with Adult Swim, he would get together with Jim Dauterive, a former executive producer of King of the Hill. Together, they would develop the backstory of their new series, Bob's Burgers, to be pitched to Fox. The initial concept for Bob's Burgers was about a family of cannibals who cooked human flesh into their burgers and sold it to their customers. The pitch was inspired by classical tales of Hannibal Lecter, and even more likely Sweeney Todd, an often retold story about a barber who would dispatch his customers down a chute into the basement of his shop, where they would be murdered and baked into pies to be sold at Mrs. Lovett's Bakery. Fox said the idea was way too dark for prime time, although they liked the rest of the concept and gave Bouchard the go-ahead to create a pitch for the show. And so he did. The result was a crude tribute to the dark show that Bob's Burgers was supposed to be. The episode was entitled Human Flesh, which centered on the suspicion that the restaurant was actually cannibalistic, baking human remains into their burgers. They would further grind the meat for the burgers in the basement.
They're down in the basement grinding the meat right now.
Just like in Sweeney Todd. It's also no coincidence that Bob's neighbor is a funeral home and crematorium run by a mortician named Mort, which is Latin for the word death. It's entirely possible that conceptually, Bob and Mort had a relationship just like Sweeney and Mrs. Lovett, a partnership for baking and cooking dead bodies into their food.
It's made with human remains from the crematorium next door.
And why do you think the store to the right is always changing in the opening sequence for every episode? It's because they likely ended up being ingredients for Bob's Burgers. It was clear at this point that the original dark concept would have a lasting effect on the show. Fox agreed to this tribute version of the pilot, as it still remained in line with their vision for the show going forward. However, they still required some primary changes to the animation style, making it more friendly for general audiences. So Bouchard and co. delivered a more bubbly version of the characters, in line with other popular animations on the air today. They further put a shirt on Bob and replaced the oldest child, Daniel, with Tina, although Dan Mintz remained the voice actor for the character. Bob's Burgers took a while to come into its own, but eventually has become one of the longest-running animated shows on the air, notable for its unique set of well-developed characters and alternative approach to comedy. Every so often, it's nice to look back, though, and see how things could have been different. You know the Bob's Burgers cookbook? Imagine what the recipes would have been like if the original concept prevailed. But I guess all that's just food for thought, right? No pun intended. Thanks guys for tuning in to The Court of Source. If you haven't seen our Rick and Morty video yet, you can get Schwifty by clicking on the video over here. Otherwise, we've had a great reception so far to our content, so we're planning to roll out a lot more. Please subscribe, like, comment, and don't hesitate to make video suggestions. I do read all the comments and would be very excited to take some ideas from the community. Take care, and as always, we'll see you in court.